Wendy Ross joins us again with the first alert forecast. Wendy, I saw you come back from dinner all bundled up. I imagine it's pretty cold out there.
Yes, it is cold out there. You have to have a jacket. You just cannot get away with shorts and flip-flops tonight. It's just too cold for that. But we are going to continue to see this cold weather. And tonight, we're going to get down. We're already in the 40s. We're going to get down into the low 40s. And it is going to be cold again tomorrow. So we're going to see these clear skies. And we are going to also get the winds to finally die down tonight. So that's going to all be part of our headlines. Today we only got up to a high of 65 degrees. 53 was the overnight low. Normally we're 52 and 71. So 71 would be nice for many of you, but we're not going to see that even tomorrow. We've got temperatures right now that are mostly in the upper 40s. Lakewood Ranch, Myakka City, you're some of the cooler spots. Parrish reporting 44 right now. Wauchula is 45 degrees. And Bradenton, 45 degrees. If you're along the beaches, it's a little bit warmer. From Longboat Key all the way down through Englewood and Punta Gorda, we're looking at temperatures in the upper 40s and even 50 in Punta Gorda. So winds are finally starting to die down along the coastline. Earlier tonight, they were much stronger, and now we're looking at 17 mile per hour winds in Anna Maria, 13 on Longboat Key, and 12 on Siesta Key. But as you move inland, the wind speeds are a little bit less, and this is also true as we move farther to the south. Minnesota at 14 miles per hour, 15 miles per hour in Boca, but Port Charlotte only reporting 10 mile per hour winds right now. And so those winds will continue to decrease as the night wears on. And we're also watching that cloud deck having moved on to the south. And we are going to experience just a little bit of cloud cover along the east coast of Florida. Some of those clouds will generate and move over here to the west coast as the winds shift around and come in out of the northeast. And we are also going to be seeing the possibility of a couple of stray showers along the east coast, but they don't make their way over to the west coast, not Sunday and not on Monday. So we are going to have a beautiful finish to the holiday weekend with lots and lots of sunshine around. Now right now it's 48 degrees, our dew point at 40, 74% humidity, winds coming in out of the north northeast, still some cloud cover out there, and this is true for most of our viewing area, but that cloud deck is going to sink to the south, and as it does so, we're going to be left with partly cloudy skies sometime after midnight tonight, and then we're going to be seeing clearing conditions, clear skies at 4 in the morning. So for the overnight time period, 42, 41 degrees. And tomorrow morning, we'll see plenty of sunshine around. Small craft advisories are in effect just for a little while tomorrow, through tomorrow. Winds out of the northeast and then shifting around to the north. And we're going to be seeing those winds as high as 20 knots, seas 3 to 5 feet, and it will be choppy in the bay and inland waters. So tonight, we are going to be getting partly cloudy skies to clearing conditions. 40 degrees for the overnight low. And this is as warm as it's going to get tomorrow, about 61 degrees. So the second day is usually cooler after the cold front comes on through. And we will start to incrementally see those temperatures moving back up into the upper 60s from Monday all the way through Wednesday. And then Wednesday night, the next cold front comes in and it cools us right back down again.